Hi there, Dan West again. Day two of my wall-hung tool cabinet build. Now, I've got to apologize for the first video because unfortunately there was something wrong with my settings. My audio was really bad, but there was really not much I could do. I had those videos already taken, so I didn't want to go through all, you can go blow through them, but at least the videos are there of what I did in that day. So this is day two. I'm going to show you here what I have and what I plan to try to get done today. This is the solid back that I'm putting on, a 3/4 back, because I'm going to be screwing into everything. I just want a solid back, and I don't want plywood. I just don't really care for plywood too much. This is the case. It's put together. It's dry fitted. So I'm going to be doing some dadoing in the case here, data work. I'm going to size this square. So I'm going to use this to really make sure my case is square. Instead of having to put clamps all over it, I'm going to glue this up in stages. So hopefully I'll get that done today. So with that, I'll get working, and I'll probably just take pictures, and then maybe what I'll probably do is just voiceover during the editing. So I'll probably be cutting a lot, any YouTubers, how that goes. And I'm really not that good at it. I'm working off an iPad, so I don't have all that great equipment, but it's something. And the main thing is you can see what's going on. I'm not concerned about the color content, and are you getting the right hues? That's for a professional or something, or someone really. I do this for fun. I don't make a living out of it. The main thing is to get the content out to you, and if you can learn from what I'm doing, or just have some amusement watching it, like I do a lot of other videos, that's my main goal. I don't have a website, so I do have an email I put at the end, if there's any comments or whatever. Other than that, let's get to it, and see you in the editing room. See you then. Okay, here we go, and here I am standing the interior of the back panel, which is a 3/4 pine back panel. I don't want some thin plywood, or I want a full 3/4, and I want solid wood. The sander here is a copy of the old Rockwell Chromie, we used to call them, the exact same copy, but it's a great standard. And of course, this is Festool. It's the only Festool I have, because they make good stuff, but man, it is so expensive. And I don't like your screw guns. I use them in France, the screw gun and the drill. They're heavy, and I just don't like it. They still got the same style. But the, I use their panel saws and everything, and they got some great equipment, but it costs so much. By the way, in my hand is my 2-meter metric rule that I brought back from France. You can't get these anymore. Now they sell aluminum ones with the printed measurement. This is aluminum, but the edges are all rounded. There's nothing, no sharp edges, and all the measurements are embossed and pressed in the metal, both front and back. So. But I like metric. You still, if you're American, and you still use metric. I use both. When I'm framing, I do a pair of material measurements. But it's just so handy in so many ways. It's too bad it has a horrible opinion, from so many people. It's not that hard to understand. And especially when you're doing like bookshelves, or when you want to divide the spaces up evenly, man, you can't be better, I'm telling you. Or you're spacing out screws or something, But I know it's an argument of questions, so everyone can do like and no problem. This little dado jig, I said before in another video that it's dedicated to that router there and it happened. It's not really what I'm thinking about it. You could take a whole different router, shape or whatever, and any kind of bit, or use the same router. Let's say I want to use it. put some quarter-inch dados or something. Put two pieces of quarter-inch underneath the panel. You know, bring the two panels together, and then put two piece of quarter-inch seam together, and cut a new path with it. Whether you're using a different router or same router, you'll have the same results. You can use a different router and put a 3/4 or a 1-inch bit in there. You're not working off a router deck. You're working off the base, and the base is contacting the sides of the jig. That's what's so good about the jig. It is so universal. Really are not dedicated to one specific, like some jigs, they're specifically made to use a router guide like we do on like a door hanger one. It goes through a template now. Not that this one. Hole Down's there, Blum Forging. He also makes other things, planes and everything, back east. Those are great hole downs. In France, we call them valets. The valet parking car. I've got some other ones. I've got the straight shaft with the metal welded onto it. They kind of work, but you got to beat the crap out of leaves. It's supple. And they really hold good. And you can see just the sheer design of it. Works really, really well. So I got done doing a bunch of dados here that I was going to do before. I knew exactly today. And there for George. The style of my little cabinet, I know it's not for a lot of guys. Some put drawers, some don't. I put such a drawers. I just like drawers, and I'm going to divide them up. I also have some drawers that I had already installed in my bench. So it's going to be a little different, tool cabinet, but one that's going to really suit my needs, especially for the kind of work I do. Here's sanding off some saw marks. I have a lot of these little different blocks that I use, sanding blocks. I either staple or spray contact cement on various types of sandpaper I put on them. Some are round, some have angles on them. I have all the types I use. This one, particular one here, is what the handle is. I can put it in my end vise, and I've used it, especially when I was doing oak drawers and stuff like that, get some rough sanding. Soft cut the marks of the saw blade. Other than that, again, I'm working off my Lubo bench is the green. There's a piece there, and I'm going to put my end vise. And it's just a handy thing that, work solid, do a lot of fitting like that, instead of having to go to a machine. But other than that, cases together, the only tool I use in this case is in the back panel. Everything else is dry. It's the green type of style as far as the joinery is concerned. But I did screw it on, see, faintly the 6-hole here on the side, and I'm going to put walnut square pegs in there. I went at Lee Valley, I went and bought the 3.5-inch square punches just made just for that. And other than that, it's going to take me a while to kind of round all the little box joints, greeny box joints. Right now they're square, but I'm going to round them off like I did my mailbox. I built a mailbox like that for my wife. Had those big document folders for blanks to pick up and drop off. Little tiny mailbox. That's my kind of glue bottle right there. I had one of the little ones that goes up and down from Rocker. I hated it. They clogged up, gagged up. That little bottle was simple, and it worked. That's what I like. So there's the box. Continue with it. I'm still trying to make some decisions on a few things. I'm going to have two sets of double doors, and I'm now thinking about changing the size of the doors. And again, of course, the doors that are going to go in there, three of them are going to be big, and the apartments are going to be small. So that's it. I hope I'm going to try to give you some shots here of it a little closer, but the lighting is so bad. I don't know. Hope I can get something better tomorrow. Other than that, I hope you get something out of it and help you have time to go in the shop yourself and have a good time working. But other than that, with that, all I can say is work safe, create good habits, and by all means make good cuts. As Ron used to tell me, Danny, don't use anybody. Yeah. There's my email address if you want to take a look at it. And other than that, I'll see you maybe tomorrow.